We got record, and here's my new friend in Jesus, Roy.
How do you Inman.
Inman.
Yes, yes.
Inman. Good name. He's got a little testimony about this morning.
Yeah, so this morning I went to bed at like 12:30 in the morning. Prior to going to bed, I felt the Lord wanted me to go to the Marriott. There's an area there where sometimes they have live music on a Friday night. But I felt led to go there. I was tired. I went to a church gathering, kind of a revival. And then while I was on my face, I had a vision of the inside of the Marriott. So that's where I went last night and brought my Bible with me. Went up there and had me a Sprite. And I asked for a Sprite. The guy gave me a 7-Up. But anyways, I was going to pay with my credit card. He said, "Oh, no. Is that all you're getting?" I said, "That's it." He said, "It's on me." I said, "All right, well, God, thank you." And so I just sat down and I was waiting. I said, maybe the Lord's going to send a prophet to come talk to me. That was my thought. That was last night. And nobody showed up. I just stayed there with my Bible open and I was just reading and didn't know why I was there. But that was what I was believing. Maybe the Lord's going to send somebody, a divine appointment. And so, and to let you know, I didn't want to go. I was tired. That's why I didn't want to go. I was real tired. I went to bed something like 12:30 in the morning. And then this morning I got up before 6, put my alarm on, and kept putting the snooze on, and finally got out here. And I pray for people on the street. We're here at the farmer's market, Midland Farmer's Market. And but anyways, it's been my desire. I've been talking to the Lord lately and saying, "Lord, when are you going to have a prophet come, somebody who moves in the prophetic, a prophetic gift or a prophet, come talk to me?" And sure enough, I was here just a second ago. I've been dealing with stomach pain, and I've prayed for a lot of folks around. And but I guess before Rich showed up here, something like, I don't know, 2 or 3 minutes before, I was just saying to the Lord, "Lord, when are you going to have somebody when are you going to have somebody come pray for me?" And that's when he came over. Reg came over, and he was just standing here, and he said to me, "What do you do?" I thought that was an interesting question. And so I answered. I told him I'm a local face painter, and we got to talking. That's how I began to, I guess, let him know this is how I pay for my bills. I'm a local evangelist. And that's how we began. He said, I can feel you're a brother, aren't you? A brother in the Lord?" And I said, "Yeah." And so anyways, he said, "The Lord sent me here. I've got a word for you." So,
the rest is his story. Yeah, God is so awesome. I can't believe that's the message the Lord wants everybody in YouTube land to know, that you can hear God for yourself. You just... My one line of evangelism is, let Jesus in, and he will cure your sin. That's the gospel and a message. And he wants to cure you so you can hear God for yourself. That's what it's all about. And,
amen.
And this is what happens. I don't know why. The Lord just said, go to the farmer's market, or what's this called?
Midland Farmer's Market.
Midland Farmer's Market in Midland, Texas. And I'll show you. I'll direct your steps. Just trust me. I said, "Okay." Here I am. And here's Roy. And Lord's gonna heal. Something's wrong with his stomach. So I laid hands on him because I'm an elder, and that's what it said. Call on elders, lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. And Lord Jesus, we're trusting you that you're gonna heal Roy completely. I command that thing to go out of his stomach now in Jesus' name. And for you out in YouTube land, if you have something wrong with you, you can ask Jesus to heal you too. So I'm going to go talk to my buddy here for a little while. God bless you out in YouTube land. Say goodbye, Rick.
Goodbye.